Let's make a custom cursor inside the framer, such as this one that you can see right now on the screen. Get sure to watch this video until the end. My name is Kia, and here is Kimo. Welcome back to my channel. The concept of having a custom cursor inside the framer is very straightforward. The first thing that we need to do is to design our custom cursor. We need to design the look and feel and even some micro animation that we would like to have. We need to design and create all the things within one component. Later on, we can assign and connect this component to any element in our web page. In this way, whenever a user mouse or cursor enter into that area or on top of that user interface element, the user will see the custom cursor instead of the normal one. Now let's see how it works in the practice. But before we go further in this video, I would like to ask you to subscribe to my channel if you are new here and if you haven't done yet. And don't forget to like this video and share it with the other designers in your community. And these are the ways that you can support my video and myself in order to continue making more videos. And please don't forget to share your opinion and thought in the comment section with me, which are very valuable, and I'm trying to kind of learn from your comments and make the videos that bring more value to you. Now, without further ado, let's get started. Okay, in order to design my custom cursor, first of all, I need to know what is the purpose of having this new design for my custom cursor. One of the reasons that we use the custom cursor in our design is to make the interactions more easier and understandable for the users. We would like to make it clear for user that what is going to trigger this interaction and what is going to happen when the user interact with that interactive element. Here in this case, in my video, I would like to have one slider as a UI element in my web page, and I would like to use the custom cursor to explain how the users can see more images in the slider by swapping left or right. Okay, the first asset or the component that I would like to add into my design or into my web page is the slider. I can find already pre-designed slider in the asset list by clicking on the insert here and coming into the interactive section, and then you can see that we have trigger, slideshow, and carousel. They are all very similar, but in my case I'm gonna use this slider, so I'm just clicking on this one, and then we will see such a component in our page. Okay, we add this slider in our web page, but we do not see anything here. However, if we zoom in, we can see that it says that we need to connect this slider to the content, and it's even explained how it works. So we need to add layers or component to make infinite auto-playing slideshow. So first of all, I'm gonna make some frame, and then here I'm going to add some image as background of this frame by clicking on the fill section here in the properties panel, and then switching to the image background and using the Unsplash plugin in order to kind of add some sort of image. Okay, let's add this one. Now I have one image. I would like to duplicate this one and then change the image. And maybe let's make it three of them. So another image here as well. Now I'm going to select the component that we add as a slider. And then here I'm going to connect it to the image number one. We immediately see that we have some sort of image that appears here in the slider, and we have all the controller of the slider as well. So we have arrow left and arrow right. Now I would like to do the same thing again and connect the image number two to slider as well. Let's do the same thing for the image number three. Okay, now let's play our prototype, and we will see that we have all the controller of the slider that we can use in order to slide between different images that we add to that slider. So the slider is working pretty good. Now there are two things that I would like to do. The first thing is to define the resizing behavior of the slider in order to make more responsive behavior. The second thing is that I would like to play a little bit with the setting of the slider in order to make more custom look and feel. So I would like to have full screen slider in my web page. So I'm going to side section, and here for the width, I'm going to set the width to fill. In this way, the kind of slider is going to fill whole frame, whole parent frame, which is basically the screen size. However, we can see that we have some gap here, which is, I guess, coming from the padding that we define in our parent layer. So I select the desktop frame, And here in the layout section, we have this padding, which I'm going to set it on 0. Now we have a full screen slider, which is nice. The second thing that I said is that I would like to make a custom behavior for the slider, or a little bit more custom. So I'm going to select the frame or the slider, and then here in the properties panel, I'm going to scroll down. And you can see that we have a bunch of stuff that we can use. For example, here we have the autoplay option, which is right now, yes, which means the images are going to slide in and out automatically. And here we have some timer, which kind of indicate the interval of this transition. So every 1.5 seconds, the image is going to slide in. This option is very important for me. I would like to make the slider works draggable as well, which means whenever the user drag the mouse and cursor on top of the kind of slider, the user can also change the swap between the images or different slides of the slider. So let's turn this on. Yes. The rest of the options, you can play around with them. For example, maybe I don't want to have this kind of dots below, which is showing how many items exist in this slider, which is not the best idea, but for now I would like to do it. Here in the dot section, I'm going to click on these three dots, and I'm going to turn off the visibility, so we won't have any dot. I would like to do the same thing for the cursors, as for the arrows here in both sides as well. So I'm going to find the arrows, which is here, and make it invisible. Now let's play the prototype one more time, and you can see that we can swap between different slide of the slider by dragging the image right and left. Okay, now let's design our custom cursor. The first thing that I would like to do is to add one text here. I would write swap here, which shows that what exactly is going to happen when the user kind of swap left and right. I don't see the text. Okay, the transparency was 0. I increase it to 100%. In this case, we will see the text. The next thing that I would like to do is to add one background to this text. So I would like to select the layout section and get the frame tool and add one frame. We're random here. Let's go to layers and see if the text is within the frame. Yes, it is. So let's change the color of the frame to black. I'm gonna position this text in the center, and let's get sure that we pin it to the center. In this way, if we change the size of the frame, you can see that it's going to the text is going to stay in the center. And I would like to increase the border radius to have more kind of circular shape here. In order to add and assign this custom cursor to our kind of slider, we need to convert this one into the component. So I'm going to right click on it and create a component. Let's rename it to custom cursor. Before we go further, let me explain what exactly I would like to do here. First thing that I would like to do is that I would like to design a macro animation or intro macro animation, which kind of animate my custom cursor when at the beginning of the kind of interaction. So when the user cursor enter to the slider, then we will have some sort of scaling animation, which kind of help the user to see this element smoother, and not suddenly out of nowhere we have our new kind of cursor in the screen. That's the intro animation. And then after that, I would like to have some sort of micro animation, which shows the user how to see the next slide, which I would like to make this feeling by kind of adding some animation to this text, basically slide it left and right, which shows to the user that, okay, how you can see more images. To make the intro animation, I have everything that I need. But in order to make that sliding in and out animation, I would like to make a copy of this text and move it to the right. When it's exit from the frame, then I'm fine with it. Then I would like to make a new variant. Let's also check the naming here. I guess like a Figma, the naming is very important. So let's get sure we have different naming for this text. Now let's add the second variant. The first variant that we have here is the initial state of our cursor. In initial state, I would like to have a very small size here, like this one. And I guess actually this is good enough, something like a zero. And the thing that's going to happen is that our kind of custom cursor is going to appear with the scale up animation. So the second variant is basically showing how the cursor is going to look like after the intro animation. I'm going to scale the frame one more time up in the variant 2. And this variant 2 is also ready. And let's add the last variant, which is going to show the swap animation. Huh? Basically, this swap text is going to replace with the other one that we have outside the frame. Now I'm going to select both of them and move them in this way that the first text exit from left side or slide out from the left side. Okay, now we have everything, every frame, every keyframe for our animations ready. Let's select the first variant and then connect it to the variant number 2. And then I'm going to set the trigger type on appears, which means whenever we see this variant, then the animation is going to happen. I'm going to set the delay to 0.1, that we have a little bit of time to understand what exactly is going to happen. So after 0.1 second, this transition is going to happen. Between variant 2 and variant 3, also we have some sort of animations. I'm going to select the variant number 2 and connect it to variant number 3. I'm going to set the trigger type on appears again. I would like to have a smooth animation. No interaction or no action from user is needed. Basically, everything is happening after each other in a sequence. Here for the delay, I'm gonna set it to 2 seconds or maybe 3 seconds to have really kind of light speed, not very fast and quick movement here. And then in this case, I'm going to select this kind of interaction one more time and put it on cycle. In this way, this transition is going to happen more than one time in a kind of loop. The design of my custom cursor is ready. Okay, now we get back to our page, select our slider, and here in the properties panel we have a cursor section. When we click on the plus button here and we click on the custom cursor, we basically can add a custom cursor that we design. Here in the component, we can open this drop down menu and click on the custom cursor or select the cursor that we built. The variant that we would like to start with is the variant number 1, of course, and I want to set this option here on replace. If you put it on follow, the default kind of cursor is going to stay and it's going to be appear, and the custom cursor that we build is going to follow basically the initial or the default cursor. Now let's run our prototype and see how our custom cursor is working. So you can see that we have the intro animation, which is okay. And then we have this really small macro animation there, which I kind of do not like it. It's a little bit so fast. I'm gonna get back to the custom cursor component that we built by double clicking on the custom cursor. And here I'm going to select the variant number 3 because I would like to reduce the speed of the animation that we had between, or the transition that we had between the variant number 3 and the variant number 2. So here in the interaction section, while I'm selecting the variant number 3, I'm going to open the interaction panel. Here you can see that the delay is very less. So I would like to maybe increase this to 3 as we had it from the variant number 2 to variant number 3 transition. And let's get back to our page and run our prototype and see how this thing is going to work. So it's swap, and then it swap to the left, the text basically, and swap to the right. Let's open our page or our design in a browser in a proper way. So we have this hero section, and when we come down, we have this custom cursor which says swap with the small or very subtle macro animation. So when I drag the image or the slider, you can see that I can swap to the left and right. Okay, That's very nice. Of course, we can go further and work more on this design and make it more appealing and more complex in terms of design itself and of course the animation that we build. However, I guess that's it for this video. I didn't want to make this video longer than this. I hope you learned something new in this video, and if it was so, please don't forget to like this video, share it with the other designers in your community, and do not forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't done yet. And at the end, of course, get sure to share your opinion and thought with me in the comment section. I'm gonna read all of them. Let's learn together, and see you in the next video.